us mess you out here.
Just break my stride. And is your home entertainment system complete? Well, we'll find out about it. But right now, let's check our four-day forecast with our staff meteorologist, Todd Glickman.
One more very hot and humid afternoon in front of us in the Triangle. Also, there'll be some scattered thunderstorms around during the latter part of the afternoon and into the evening, and a couple of them could contain some pretty good downpours of rain and strong gusty winds. Temperatures today will be in the mid-90s, humidity continuing to be fairly high with a southwesterly wind. Then for tonight, becoming partly cloudy overnight lows near 70 degrees. We'll take the edge off the temperatures a little bit each of the next couple of days. That's certainly good news. It'll be partly cloudy, 82, 85 tomorrow, and cool into the low 60s tomorrow night. For Wednesday, sunshine and dry each day with highs in the middle 80s. And with the WPTF four-day forecast, I'm Todd Glickman.
Currently at the Raleigh-Durham Airport, 86, and the heat index now standing at 93.
Just because you recently bought a compact disc player, a video cassette recorder, a video disc player, and a video camcorder does not mean your home entertainment system is complete. One innovative company is a few months from introducing a home laser projector. It traces a pattern of light on your wall that moves in time to the music from your stereo. And Larry Brooks of Orion Industries believes many home stereo systems will soon have one.
It is a true laser, too, rather than something we just call a laser. It is a laser. And we are on the verge of breakthroughs that we hope to get it down to about $400 for the consumer. At that point, we feel that most people would be willing to spend that to put a laser in with their stereo package in their homes.
Brooks says it'll be a low-powered laser, bright enough to see the pattern clearly, but not so bright that it'll blind you if you look directly into it. Roger Field on the NBC Radio Network.
WPTF Sunday Focus, I can see clearly now. Johnny Nash at 12:50.
clearly a sunny day, 86 degrees in the Triangle. And speaking of sunny and summer, Joanna Langfield reviews some summer movies.
It's been a banner year at the nation's box offices, and the biggest and probably the best season of movies is just upon us. Ladies and gentlemen, beware! It's the summer movie season! What makes summertime historically a hot time for big movies? Chris Connolly of Premiere Magazine has an interesting perspective.
Still find a vast number of movies released during the summer because, as Willie Sutton said when asked why he robbed banks, that's where the money is. I mean, people are out of school, people are interested in seeing movies, TVs, and reruns. So it's a great time to go out and see films.
Estimates are some 100 motion pictures of all shapes, sizes, and quality will be released before Labor Day, with big stars like Sylvester Stallone, Paul Hogan, Eddie Murphy, Bette Midler, and Clint Eastwood. We'll see. Fantasies, comedies, action, adventure, comedy, adventure, drama, romances, western, thrillers, gangster comedies, and even one movie that mixes live action and cartoons. Fasten your seatbelts, everybody. This could turn out to be a wonderful ride. I'm Joanna Langfield.
This is a Wall Street Journal weekend focus on putting up less for a mutual fund. I'm Sal Giangrasso. Details in a moment.
Three new services have been added to WPTF's Channel 36 on Cablevision of Raleigh.
Now, look for the time, the day, and date.
And the current weather forecast, 24 hours a day.
All of these new services make Channel 36 even more valuable.
And, of course, you'll continue to receive news and sports updates and community announcements on Datebook.
And you'll continue to hear all of our programming from WPTF AM Stereo 680.
WPTF's Channel 36 on Cablevision of Raleigh.
Now with the current weather forecast.
24 hours a day.
It may cost less to get into that mutual fund you've been eyeing. Since October's stock market crash, some big funds have slashed the amount of money they require investors to put up in order to buy in. For example, Fund Trust Group cut its minimum to $1,000 from $100,000. In theory, that should attract more money to the funds. But such moves are sparking some controversy. One Vanguard Group executive says investors don't make decisions based on minimum requirements, and he adds you shouldn't sell funds like you sell a jar of peanut butter. What's more, some mutual fund analysts say lowering the minimum won't significantly increase fund assets. They say even if a fund attracts a number of new holders this way, their investments are likely to be small and therefore won't have any big impact on the size of the fund. Besides, the critics say an increase in holders can boost fund expenses like printing and postage costs to the point where larger investors might desert them. This has been a Wall Street Journal Weekend Focus.
WPTF Sunday Focus at 12:52. We're spotlighting the year 1975 this weekend. Here is Freddie Fender.
If he brings you happiness, then I wish you both the best. It's your happiness that matters most of all. But if he ever breaks your heart, if the teardrop ever starts, I'll be there before the next teardrop falls. Verdad y te da felicidad. Te deseo lo más bueno para los dos. Pero si te hace llorar, a mí me puedes hablar. Y estaré contigo cuando triste estás. I'll be there anytime you need me by your side to drive away every teardrop that you cry. And if he ever leaves you blue, just remember
I love you, and I'll be there before the next teardrop falls.
...1975, our spotlight year, and that's Freddie Fender, Before the Next Teardrop Falls.
Is that bacon I smell cooking?
You bet.
But we agreed we were going to cut down on salt.
We did, but this is Armour Lower Salt Bacon.
Lower salt bacon? There's no such thing.
I'm sure there is. Look at the package.
Well, I'll be.
Bacon, Armour Bacon, it's the bacon lover's bacon. Taste the way great bacon's supposed to taste.
Hot and sizzling.
You won't miss the salt you're missing. Bacon, Armour Bacon.
Armour Lower Salt Bacon lets you give up salt without giving up great taste.
It's light on salt, but never light on taste.
What are you eating now?
It's a donut.
But I thought...
We never said anything about sugar.
Oh.
Now there are two ways to enjoy the great taste of Armour Bacon at Harris Teeter. Their regular bacon, a family favorite for years, and Armour Lower Salt Bacon with one-third less salt and all the delicious Armour taste. Just one bite and you'll know why Armour is the bacon lover's bacon.
1256 on WPTF, and time to take a look at what's going on around town this afternoon. And the Ethnic Heritage Ensemble will have a concert of ancient and futuristic sounds today at 7:30 at the Arts Center in Carrboro. That's at 300 G East Main Street. Tickets are $6 and $5 for Arts Center members.
This afternoon at 3 o'clock in the North Carolina Museum of History, which is at 109 East Jones Street in Raleigh, and this will be in the auditorium, The Complete Beatles, the first Beatles rockumentary, tracing the group's career from the very beginning to the final days, captures the charm and the strong personalities of the Beatles and the wariness that brought on its breakout.
And a Shape Note scene will be today at 2 o'clock at the Mordecai Chapel at Old Wake Forest Road and Mimosa Street. All singers are welcome and music is available and it is free.
And there will be a matinee today by the McCrae Repertory Professional Theater Company in Durham of the play The Amen Corner. The performance will be at the Rogers Herb School Auditorium in Durham this afternoon, 3:15. Tickets cost $9.50. 12:57 now. Blood, Sweat, and Tears.
What goes up must come down. Spinning wheel, got to go round. Talking about your troubles, it's a crying sin. Like a painted pony, let the spinning wheel spin. You got no money, you got no hope.
WPTF, AM Stereo 680, Raleigh, Durham, Chapel Hill.
Good afternoon. I'm Adam Hochberg, WPTF News. Stories we're watching. Oliver North comes to Raleigh, drawing both fans and pans. A Ku Klux Klan march in Wilson becomes violent. A pileup in Cary involving five vehicles injures six people. And the state's gubernatorial candidates take their campaign south of the border. We'll have details on these and other stories, plus the exclusive four-day forecast for the Triangle following ABC News. It's 1 o'clock.
From ABC News, I'm Harley Carnes. When it is so hot you think your brain's gonna cook, and your crops won't grow, and dust devils whirl as you walk, it's enough to drive a man to drink. Daryl Drager owns the Blue Parrot Bar in Napoleon, North Dakota.
I've seen guys come in here that I don't think I've ever seen them in the bar. All of a sudden, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, they just...
Air Council and Beef Board. For the ABC Information Network, I'm Harley Carnes.
WPTF News Time is 1:05. Good afternoon. I'm Adam Hochberg. Some 300 people came to cheer him. Some 150 came to jeer him. Lieutenant Colonel Oliver North was in Raleigh last night to speak at a fundraiser for two Republicans running for statewide office, Lieutenant Governor candidate Jim Gardner and Attorney General candidate Samuel Wilson. The supporters paid $100 apiece to listen to North. The protesters marched outside. One of them was Gail Ferries.
Ollie North has violated the Constitution. He's broken the law. He's lied to Congress. He's obstructed justice. He's supported terrorists, the Contras, who are killing women and children, and supported drug dealers, and we don't feel that someone like this should be here in North Carolina supporting somebody running for Attorney General of the state.
North said Gardner and Wilson offer the kind of conservative leadership North Carolina needs. Earlier in the day, participants in another event took some shots at one of North Carolina's conservative leaders. Senator Jesse Helms was criticized frequently at a march by homosexuals from around the state. About 2,000 people took part in the parade in downtown Raleigh. Among their chants was 2468. Jesse Helms is out of date. In Wilson, it was the Ku Klux Klan parading through downtown, and by the time that march was over yesterday, several people were injured. Four had been arrested. About 1,000 spectators watched the 25 white supremacists walk through the streets. First, words were exchanged between Klansmen and spectators, then stones began flying. Two of the injured were police officers trying to break up the scuffle. Two spectators were arrested for disorderly conduct, two Klansmen arrested on weapons charges. A van carrying a South Carolina church group overturned on Interstate 95 yesterday near Selma, killing one person and injuring 17 others. It happened when the van driver swerved to avoid rear-ending another vehicle. The dead woman identified as 78-year-old Daisy Huggins of Lamar, South Carolina. The van was registered to the Church of Christ in Lamar. In Cary last night, six people were hurt in an accident at the intersection of U.S. 1 and U.S. 64, an accident involving three cars and two motorcycles. Police are blaming an accused drunk driver who they say rear-ended a string of cars waiting at a stoplight, causing a chain reaction wreck. North Carolina's gubernatorial candidates took their show on the road yesterday, debating each other in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, site of the convention for the North Carolina Bar Association. Democrat Bob Jordan apologized for a remark he made earlier in the campaign, a remark referring to some eastern North Carolinians as rednecks. Republican incumbent Jim Martin alleged Jordan has a hidden political agenda that he's not sharing with the voters. Earlier in the week, Martin told reporters he'll continue to defend himself against Democrats' claims that he's a sitting governor. He says Democrats would have the voters believe that everything good that's happened during Martin's years in office should be credited to his predecessor.
What they're trying to do now is get you to believe that Jim Hunt has been much more effective during the 3.5 years of my administration than he was during his own.
Martin says during the campaign he'll be responding to Jordan's criticisms in turn and won't be, in his words, moping all the time. And finally, from our civic pride file, Raleigh resident David Singleton has put the capital city on the map in the world of tobacco spitting. The 18-year-old has won the 34th annual National Tobacco Spitting Contest, his winning spit measuring 28 feet, 10 inches. This is WPTF News.
My wife Sylvia says I'm only embarrassing myself by advertising on the radio for people to feed me. She says I'll never find anybody who'll be content to cook only my favorite, that fresh Holly Farms chicken, night after night after night. And for once, she's right. But I have found two very nice couples and one elderly woman in Kernersville who've agreed to make up my favorite Holly Farms dishes on alternating Mondays and Wednesdays. Why, just the other night, Miss Meyer cooked up an amazing southern fried chicken with cream gravy and mashed potatoes. It was a sight to behold. Put Sylvia's to shame. Sorry, hon, but I don't bite the hand that feeds me. So come on, folks, don't be shy. If you've got a great Holly Farms chicken recipe you're just dying to try out on somebody, write me, J.R., Box 5627, Winston-Salem, North Carolina, 27113. Tuesday nights are still open. And if it's really good, I'll give you a plug on my next radio commercial.
109 at WPTF with our exclusive four-day forecast for the Triangle. Here's staff meteorologist Todd Glickman.
Considerable sunshine for the rest of today, but very hot and humid with a lot of haze in the air, too. Light winds out of the south and west. Temperatures in the middle 90s. There'll be thunderstorms around this afternoon and evening, a few of them containing strong gusty winds and some downpours of rain. It'll be around 70 degrees tonight with the strong thunderstorms ending. For tomorrow, partly cloudy, less humid, better visibility, and not so hot, 80 to 85, cooling to the low 60s Monday night. Tuesday and Wednesday, fair and dry weather, sunny, seasonably warm, in the mid-80s each day. And with the WPTF four-day forecast, I'm Todd Glickman.
86 degrees at Raleigh-Durham International. From the Triangle's News Center, I'm Adam Hochberg, WPTF News.
Good afternoon, I'm Kathy Reed on WPTF Sunday Focus.
Along with Tom Smither, and coming up in this hour, Dr. Joyce Brothers talks about the important job of a manicurist.
Controlling your weight is the focus on Health Digest.
And Donald Regan comments on the economic legacy of Ronald Reagan.
All on a Sunday magazine for your ears.
WPTF Sunday Focus. Rick Astley now, never gonna give you up.
Yeah.
1:14 on WPTF Sunday Focus. Rick Astley and Never Gonna Give You Up.
And if you think it's hot outside and muggy, you are right. Raleigh-Durham International Airport now reporting 90 degrees. And the heat index, which is a combination of the temperature and the humidity, how it affects and feels on the human body, now standing at 99.
Ooh, hot one out there.
This is Dr. Joyce Brothers. In what industry do you sit and hold a client's hand for an hour? Dr. Eve Prang of Carlsbad, California, asked manicurists in her audience. Many of them haven't had their hands held and patted and stroked since they were going steady in high school, she reminded her audiences. Their husbands don't do it, their kids don't. You're often the only one who holds their hands, so do it well. Remember, you aren't just holding somebody's hand and giving her prettier nails. You're also relieving stress and building self-esteem. Other psychologists have had similar messages for groups. You're always there, hairdressers are told, through the good times and bad times. You may know more about the client in your chair than her closest friend and relatives. You may be the only person in her life who actually touches her. Hairdressers and manicurists can't learn to be psychologists, but trained psychologists can teach them to touch and listen well. This is Dr. Joyce Brothers on the NBC Radio Network.
You painted up your lips and rolled and curled your tinted hair. Ruby, are you contemplating going out somewhere? The shadow on the wall tells me the sun is going down. It wasn't me who started that old crazy Asian war, but I was proud to go into my patriotic shore. Yes, it's true that I'm not the man I used to be. It's hard to love a man whose legs are bent and paralyzed, and the wants and the needs of a woman your age, Ruby, I realize. But it won't be long, I've heard them say, until I'm not around. Cause I just heard the slamming of the door. The way I know I've heard it slam 100 times before. And if I could move, I'd get my gun and put her in the ground. Take your love to town. For God's sakes, turn around.
WPTF, Kenny Rogers in the first edition.
Health Digest, a report on environmental and health issues in the news.
Many overweight individuals think they have unfortunately inherited a predisposition to become fat, and they may be right. It is difficult to separate the effects of our genes from the effects of our environment. Families not only share the same genes, but eating habits as well. Scientists have studied the influence of nature versus nurture by comparing the weights of twins who were adopted by different families. They've also looked at foster children's weights and those of their natural and substitute parents. The findings suggest that a strong genetic factor predisposes people to obesity. Look closely at your family, but keep in mind that whether or not your genetic potential becomes a reality is influenced by your environment, like the constant availability of rich and fatty foods. You can control your future weight by developing healthy eating and exercise habits. For Health Digest, I'm Dr. Elizabeth Whelan, Executive Director of the American Council on Science and Health.
Chevy invites you to drive a pickup like you've never driven before.
Listen to the heartbeat.
Now Chevy S10 pickup is available with a 4.3-liter Vortec V6. The biggest engine ever offered in a compact pickup. 160 swirl Ford injected horsepower, 230 pounds of torque. The most V6 power and torque of any compact pickup. It's available in two-wheel drive or four-wheel drive S10s. And at a price low enough to make your heart beat faster than ever. Drive Chevy S10 with an available 4.3-liter Vortec V6. And feel a pickup like you've never driven before. Chevy S10 pickup.
That's today's Chevy truck.
Hi, I'm Bart Whitner, host of WPTF's Open Line. I hope you've heard that we're putting together a 10-day trip to the Soviet Union, but just in case you haven't, we are from the 30th of September to the 9th of October, and we'd really like to have you come along with us. We're working with American Travel on the trip, and I've been to Russia with them before, and they know what they're doing. We've heard a lot about Russia recently, what with glasnost and the president's recent summit, and this is your golden opportunity to wander through the Kremlin, for instance. Its chapels and cathedrals will take your breath away. The price for the entire tour from Raleigh back to Raleigh, and including all transportation, lodging, three meals a day, and sightseeing, and taxes, is $2,495 a person, double occupancy, and that's a bargain. About the only thing you'll have to spend for is bring-homers. We've had 30 seats blocked out for us, but we do have to know something by the end of this month, so don't wait, because there might not be room for you. Call Connie at American Travel at 481-1212, or toll free at 1-800-433-3212. Come on, go with me.
WPTF with Satchmo.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white. The bright, blessed day, the dark, sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. Them grow.
look at the WPTF 4-day forecast. Here's staff meteorologist Todd Glickman.
Hot and steamy weather will be with us one more time today in the Triangle. The good news is we do have some relief in sight for each of the next couple of days. If you're starting off the work week on a nice note, weather-wise, I think you'll enjoy it because temperatures will be down in the 80s with low humidity. But as far as today is concerned, still a real steamer out there, mid-90s with that haze and humidity. Also, some scattered thunderstorms around, and some of those thunderstorms will be accompanied by some strong gusty winds and good downpours of rain. Temperatures overnight will fall only into the near the 70-degree mark. For tomorrow, partly cloudy, less humid, and temperatures 80 to 85. Cooler tomorrow night, 60 to 65, sunny mid-80s for Tuesday and Wednesday. And with the WPTF 4-day forecast, I'm Todd Glickman.
And right now in High Woods, we have 90 degrees with a heat index of 99. And with a commentary on Ronald Reagan's economic legacy, here's Donald Reagan.
The leaders of the developed world have been meeting in Toronto. High on their agenda has been prolonging the economic recovery these major countries have been enjoying. Left unsaid has been the key role of the United States in leading the economic revival of the entire world. Remember the boom and the bust of the late 70s and the early 80s? Double-digit inflation was followed by soaring unemployment. By mid-1982, pessimism was rampant in Western Europe, Canada, Japan, and the United States. But Reagan stood firm for his policies of free markets, low taxes, and deregulation, and they began to pay off. From November 1982 to the present, the United States has experienced a record peacetime economic expansion, with 15 million new jobs created. For all the talk about our trade deficit, it was the United States' demand for foreign goods that helped bring our trading partners out of their slump. It's not surprising, then, that foreign critics of the Reagan economic policy have been silent lately. But I am surprised that Reagan economic policies haven't gotten more credit at home. More Americans are working than ever before. Inflation is low, and the economy is continuing to grow. My view is that Ronald Reagan's policies are responsible for this remarkable economic record. This is Don Reagan on the NBC Radio Network.
WPTF! We'll be right back. is Weekend Sports. Hello, everybody. I'm Bob Berger on the NBC Radio Network. It's another blistering day at the ballparks, and by now, Baltimore and Boston have broken a sweat at Fenway. After one inning of play, Red Sox lead the Orioles 4-1. Jim Rice, a two-run homer. Mike Greenwell hit his 14th, also a two-run shot. He's hit in 17 straight games now and batting close to 350. Lynn homered for Baltimore. Set to start Yanks and Indians, Tigers at Toronto. Coming up later, Twins at Oakland for 2A. Start the day six games in front of Minnesota. Seattle stays home to play Kansas City. Milwaukee's at California. And tonight, Texas takes on Chicago. Over in the National League, the Pirates and Expos are about to get underway in Montreal. And the Expos are without pitcher Floyd Yeomans, who's been suspended indefinitely by the commissioner for failing to comply with his drug testing program. It was 105 degrees at Wrigley Field yesterday, and in the sixth inning, things reached the boiling point. Rafael Palmeiro homered off Bob Ojeda, who then hit Andre Dawson with a pitch.
That's part of the game. I don't care. I'm not out there to make friends. I'm not out there to hit somebody on purpose either. It's a game. It's a business. And I'm not going to mess with anybody's wallet by drilling somebody. But if I come inside and then, a guy can't get out of the way, it's part of the game.
But not a part the hitter's happy about. Dawson and Ojeda exchange words, not punches. Both benches emptied. However, the umpires kept their cool and the players apart. Round two this afternoon in Chicago. This is Weekend Sports.
Greetings, sports fans. Here's news about how you can get a free video cassette from Sports Illustrated. The all-new NFL Football Follies. 44 fun-filled minutes of the NFL's greatest flubs, fumbles, and flukes ever. All you do is call 1-800-284-7100, and you'll get the Football Follies video free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. I bet you've been wanting to subscribe anyway, and now SI is over 47% off the cover price. Three easy monthly payments of $9.89 each. You can even put it on a credit card. What a bargain for 25 weeks of America's best sports coverage. That means baseball, basketball, football, and more. You name it, SI covers it. And don't forget, you'll get the Football Follies video free. A deal this good won't last forever, so call Sports Illustrated toll-free 1-800-284-7100. That's 1-800-284-7100. Get your free video before it's gone!
There's little left to do but fight, and it's Tyson Spinks tomorrow night in Atlantic City. They waited on ABC TV yesterday, and the champion is 218 and a quarter, Spinks 212 and a quarter pounds. Tyson will attack. He always does. But how will Spinks counter?
Perhaps he'll run or try to give me some cute move, be awkward, but I'm prepared for everything. I trained for 7 weeks, and I had the most awkwardest sparring partners. And what can I say? I'm just ready to go.
The soap opera surrounding the champion hasn't distracted him, Tyson says, and he remains a heavy favorite to retain the title. It's tea time at Wimbledon. No tennis today. Second week action gets underway tomorrow, and Martina Navratilova is still on track to win her seventh straight singles title and ninth overall.
I feel good. I feel that if I stay focused and play as well as I can, that I have as good a chance to win as anybody else out there.
Her only competition should be Steffi Graf, unless Martina looks past her opponents. Jimmy Connors survived a 4-hour five-set match Saturday against Derek Rostano, so Jimmy's in the round of 16. You're listening to NBC's Weekend Sports. Larry Nelson takes a four-shot lead with him into the final round of the Atlanta Golf Classic. Nelson is 21 under par. Paul Eisinger's in second place. In other golf news, Nick Faldo, who finished second to Curtis Strange in the U.S. Open playoff last week, won the French Open. Harold Henning has the lead at the seniors event at Oklahoma City, and Patty Sheehan's in front at the LPGA tournament in Wilmington, Delaware. Auto racing, the 400 at the Michigan International Speedway. Rusty Wallace is the leader. This is Bob Berger, Weekend Sports, on the NBC Radio Network.
You're in tune with WPTF Sunday Focus. We have 90 degrees at Raleigh-Durham International Airport. Heat index now standing at 99.
And Tom, coming up, we're going to have our NBC Extra report on happy landings, healthy stay, and our Wall Street Journal Weekend Focus at 1:50 on offshore investment scams. That's all coming up on WPTF Sunday Focus.
And today we are spotlighting the year 1975. Hamilton, Joe, Frank, and Reynolds.
Baby, falling in love again.
1:38 on WPTF Sunday Focus, Hamilton, Joe, Frank, and Reynolds, and Fallen in Love.
WPTF Sunday Focus date book for June 26. 61 years ago, in 1917, the first troops of the American Expeditionary Force arrived in France during World War I on this date. 42 years ago, June 26, 1946, the United Nations, the international organization of world states which aims to promote peace and international cooperation, was chartered. President Truman.
Oh, what a great day this can be in history. The charter of the United Nations, which you are now signing, is a solid structure upon which we can build for a better world. History will honor you for it. For it is a declaration of great faith by the nations of the earth, faith that war is not inevitable.
On June 26, in 1959, President Dwight D. Eisenhower joined Britain's Queen Elizabeth II in ceremonies officially opening the St. Lawrence Seaway. June 26, 1963, President John Kennedy visited the Berlin Wall and declared to the German people, Ich bin ein Berliner.
2,000 years ago, the proudest boast was, Civis Romanus sum. Today, in the world of freedom, the proudest boast is, Ich bin ein Berliner.
June 26, 1971, promoter Bill Graham announced the closing of the legendary Fillmore East and Fillmore West nightclubs that had brought little-known groups into the mainstream of music.
If five people left a Grateful Dead Miles Davis concert and they came to see the Grateful Dead, and five out of 5,000 bought a Miles Davis album, I may have helped them to be introduced to Miles Davis or the Staple Singers or Roland Kirk or Yusef Lateef or some of the others. But I don't know if we influenced them so much in music. What we did is brought in what they liked because we're in business, but we brought in what I thought they should also like. And obviously, mass white America did not eat a lot of Miles Davis or Chuck Berry or B.B. King or Luther Allison, but at least some of them got them.
On this June 26, actress Eleanor Parker is 66 and singer Billy Davis is 48. Hear the weekday edition of Datebook Mondays through Fridays on WPTF Focus with Mike Rayleigh at 6:27 p.m. With the WPTF Sunday Focus Datebook for June 26, I'm Tom Koenig.
My wife Sylvia says I'm only embarrassing myself by advertising on the radio for people to feed me. She says I'll never find anybody who'll be content to cook only my favorite, that fresh Holly Farms chicken, night after night after night. And for once, she's right. But I have found two very nice couples and one elderly woman in Kernersville who've agreed to make up my favorite Holly Farms dishes on alternating Mondays and Wednesdays. Why, just the other night, Miss Meyer cooked up an amazing southern fried chicken with cream gravy and mashed potatoes. It was a sight to behold. Put Sylvia's to shame. Sorry, hon, but I don't bite the hand that feeds me. So come on, folks, don't be shy. If you've got a great Holly Farms chicken recipe you're just dying to try out on somebody, write me, J.R., Box 5627, Winston-Salem, North Carolina, 27113. Tuesday nights are still open. And if it's really good, I'll give you a plug on my next radio commercial.
Honey, what's the fixed rate now?
I don't know. I think it's around 10, 10 and a half, 11.
Well, what if I were to tell you that there was a place that offers 8 7/8 30-year fixed rate financing? Would you say that was good?
I would say that it sounds great, but there's got to be some kind of catch, like 25% down or something.
Oh, nothing like that. How about 5% down plus all closing costs paid and a monthly payment as low as $514.33?
$514.33? Don't joke like this, honey. That's almost what we're paying in rent. What you're telling me is that there's a way out of here and that we can own something of our very own.
Find all this at the Richlands. Richland Run from 59.5. Richland Towns from 74.5. The Richlands offer you beautiful living and a major tax deduction with swimming and tennis to boot. Call 787-9706. That's 787-9706. You may qualify for 8 7/8 and not even know it. The Richlands, an equal housing opportunity community on Durley Road, 2 miles from 70 West in Raleigh.
WPT.
WPTF Cindy Lauper, time after time.
And the time is 1:46, and it's time to take a look at the weather forecast. It's a hot one out there. Here's our staff meteorologist, Todd Glickman.
One more very hot and humid afternoon in front of us in the Triangle. Also, there'll be some scattered thunderstorms around during the latter part of the afternoon and into the evening, and a couple of them could contain some pretty good downpours of rain and strong gusty winds. Temperatures today will be in the mid-90s, humidity continuing to be fairly high with a southwesterly wind. Then for tonight, becoming partly cloudy overnight, lows near 70 degrees. We'll take the edge off the temperatures a little bit each of the next couple of days. That's certainly good news. It'll be partly cloudy, 82, 85 tomorrow, and cool into the low 60s tomorrow night. For Wednesday, sunshine and dry each day with highs in the middle 80s. And with the WPTF four-day forecast, I'm Todd Glickman.
And currently at Raleigh-Durham International, 90 degrees, and with the heat index is sitting at 99.
NBC Extra, happy landings, healthy stay. I'm Andy Fisher.
You can see it in the lengthening lines at the airport check-in counters. You can see it in the thickening traffic on American highways. The vacation season is heating up once again. And once again, Dr. Harold Silverman is predicting a lot of vacations will run aground because vacationers overlook one important thing.
They plan for everything else. They plan for their hotels and their transportation and where they're going to eat and where they're going to stay and what they're going to do. But the last thing in the world they remember is to plan for their health needs. And I think that depending upon your own susceptibilities, your own history, whether or not you have any chronic conditions, you have to plan regardless. You have to plan to make sure if you take chronic medication, you have to plan, make sure you have enough medicine with you to last the entire trip. If you're susceptible to some of the more common travel problems, like motion sickness, jet lag, or whatever, you have to prepare for that if you're going to be using a form of transportation where that comes into play, or if you're going to be traveling to an area of the world where a particular problem like traveler's diarrhea is known.
Dr. Silverman is a pharmacologist who has made a study of the ways people mess up their vacations by falling prey to travel ailments. We'll hear about one of them, jet lag, next time. I'm Andy Fisher on the NBC Radio Network.
There'll be a summer driver education class offered at all Wake County public high schools, beginning this coming Monday and ending July 21st. Eligible students must be 15 years old by June 1st, 1988, and not older than 18. There's no charge for this course. Register by calling the Wake County Driver Education Office, 790-2545, on Monday morning. WPTF, in touch with the Triangle.
Journal Weekend Focus on offshore investment scams. I'm Joan Furstenberg. Details in a moment.
Hi, Tom Baudette from Motel 6 with inside tips for planning trips. We'll clear off the kitchen table and spread your stuff out all over. Road maps, pencils, paper, even a compass and a protractor just for effect. We'll put a pencil behind your ear, get that I'm busy look on your face, and go to work. The family will look on in awe at the precision and effort involved. Well, then tell them you work better alone. Once they leave the room, call our itinerary planning service at 505-891-6161. Tell us where you're going, how far you want to drive each day, and we'll tell you the best way to go and all about Motel 6 locations along the way. We got the lowest prices of any national chain, and our rooms are always clean and comfortable. Okay, we'll call the family back in, show them the route, and they'll reward your efforts with a ticker tape parade, or at least a hearty round of huzzas. But don't worry, that planning service thing will be our little secret. I'm Tom Baudette from Motel 6, and we'll lead the light on for you.
If you get a call from overseas offering a great investment deal, be very careful. Telephone con artists are popping up all over Central America and the Caribbean. No one knows how many there are, but the problem is expected to grow because of advances in telephone technology and declines in international phone rates. Also, they're almost impossible for regulators to shut down. That's because the con men rarely break local laws, whether they operate in Bermuda, Costa Rica, or St. Kitts, and international fraud laws are fuzzy. Investigators say these offshore con men operate the same as anywhere. They promise huge returns on your money for investing in everything from gold mines to jojoba beans. And a lot of times, these boiler rooms simply change names after one scam and call the same investors using a different piece of bait. So the next time you hear a crackling on the phone line and you don't know anyone in Costa Rica, hang up. This has been a Wall Street Journal Weekend Focus.
5 minutes away from 2 o'clock on WPTF Sunday Focus, Kathy Reed along with Tom Smither this afternoon. And early in life, we respond to different tastes, and that's the subject today on Duke Healthline as Kay Miller talks with Susan Schiffman. She's a psychology professor and expert on taste and smell.
Could you tell us how newborn infants respond and what their responses to various foods mean?
Newborns respond with facial expressions to tastes. When you drop sweet taste on a baby's tongue, it will smile and look very relaxed. If you put sour on a baby's tongue, it will purse its lips, like when you eat a lemon. And if you put bitter on a baby's tongue, it sticks out its tongue and says, ugh. We know that expression very well. But it's interesting that babies don't respond to salt. There is no innate gustofacial response to salt. In fact, babies have no preference for salt up to the age of about 7 months of age. So salting a baby's food is not necessary. The salting of foods comes from mama when she's tasting it. So I think one thing for mother to realize is that you don't have to salt the food for the baby to enjoy it.
Should children, or infants, I should say, be fed only the foods that they like then?
Well, how do we really know that they like them? The way we suspect that we know they like them is by the smile. I think one thing that I suggest to mothers is not to try to get that baby to smile all the time when they're eating food. Obviously, the way to do it is to feed sweet foods. Very frequently, mothers will mix fruit with the vegetables, and so that all together the food has a sweet taste to it. I suggest not to do this, because you want the child to associate certain tastes, like that of broccoli or carrots, with the proper nutrition. If they learn to associate sweet taste with the nutritional nutritional things that happen to you when you eat broccoli or whether you eat beans, you don't want them to associate sweet taste with that. You want them to associate with the taste of the vegetables themselves. So don't mix the sweet with the vegetables.
This is Kay Miller with Susan Schiffman on Duke Health Line for WPTF Focus.
What a day for a daydream. What a day for a daydreaming boy. And I'm lost in a daydream. Dreaming about my bundle of joy. And even if time ain't really on my side, it's one of those days for taking a walk outside. I'm blowing the day to take a walk in the sun and follow my pace on somebody's new mowed lawn. I've been having a sweet dream. I've been dreaming since I woke up today. It's starring me in my sweet dream. 'Cause she's the one makes me feel this way. And even if time is passing me by, I couldn't care less about the dues you say I got. Tomorrow I'll pay the dues for dropping my loan. I'll find a place for being a sleepy for a daydream. Custom made for a daydreaming boy. I'm lost in a daydream. Dreaming about my bundle of joy.
WPTF, AM Stereo 680, Raleigh-Durham, Chapel Hill.
Good afternoon. I'm Adam Hochberg, WPTF News. Stories we're watching, Governor Martin and Lieutenant Governor Jordan take their race for the governor's seat on the road. The State Hazardous Waste Treatment Commission grapples with its next step now that the legislature has changed the commission's duties, and Piedmont Airlines gets a new management team. We'll have details on these and other stories, plus the four-day forecast for the Triangle following ABC News. It's 2 o'clock.
From ABC News, I'm Harley Carnes. An A320 jet airliner crashed during an air show demonstration in eastern France this morning. Two people died. At least 80 of the 127 people on board were hurt. Witnesses described a low pass in the landing configuration, and ABC's Bill Dowell says passengers described it as too low.
One of the passengers who was on board the Air France A320 said she could hear the branches of trees scraping the fuselage moments before it hit the ground with a jolt. A fire broke out in the front of the plane. The passengers immediately jumped through emergency exit chutes and began running, expecting an explosion at almost any moment. Witnesses described seeing two passengers carrying a third on crutches. Spectators at the Mulhouse-Basel Airport, where the plane had been making a demonstration flight, said they saw the plane fly over the runway with its landing gear down and then disappear behind some trees at the end. A column of black smoke billowed out over the trees. Bill Dowell, ABC News, Paris.
More after this.
If you have constipation, listen to what Bette Castelluccio says about Dulcolax laxatives.
My life is just too busy to take chances knowing that I'm going to have the anxiety, the cramps, the discomfort. Predictability is vital. Dulcolax gives me that predictability.
For constipation, Dulcolax suppositories can work in 15 minutes to an hour. Dulcolax tablets predictably overnight.
Dulcolax gives me the relief without the anxiety. It's fast, dependable, and gentle. It works. It really works.
For occasional use, use only as directed.
The feeling's so nice. Natural Lipton and Ice.
Instant tea or tea bags. Lipton iced tea refreshes your whole body right.
Natural Lipton and Ice. Refresh your body right. As it goes down. You feel it all around. It's so clean. It's so light. The taste is just right. Natural Lipton and Ice. Refresh your body naturally.
A small quake in Southern California this morning. ABC's Jane Platt says the tremor shook her awake in her bed this morning.
The quake was centered about...
Hey, let me tell you, Ace is the painting place for me.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware man.
For the ABC Information Network, I'm Harley Carnes.
WPTF News Time is 2:05. Good afternoon. I'm Adam Hochberg. The North Carolina governor's race traveled south of the border this weekend as Governor Martin and Lieutenant Governor Bob Jordan squared off in a debate in Myrtle Beach, where the North Carolina Bar Association is holding its annual convention. Martin referred back to Jordan's remark earlier in the campaign, in which Jordan referred to some eastern North Carolinians as rednecks. Martin says he's asking for everybody's vote, regardless of race, creed, or neck color. Jordan apologized at the debate for the redneck comment. Also at the debate, Martin said if he had veto power, he would have used it last year when the legislature passed a phosphate detergent ban. He said he'll continue to work to cut the state abortion fund if he's reelected, but Jordan said if he's elected governor, he would not. As ABC reported, in Raleigh last night, two Republican candidates pulled out some heavy artillery in their campaigns for statewide office. Lieutenant Governor hopeful Jim Gardner and Attorney General candidate Samuel Wilson brought Lieutenant Colonel Oliver North to town to speak on their behalf at a $100 a plate fundraiser. North called for more Republicans to be elected both at the state and national level. About 150 protesters marched outside the Carr Scott building where the event was held. This weekend marks the beginning of a new era for the State Hazardous Waste Treatment Commission. Friday, the General Assembly ruled the commission must stop its efforts to locate a waste treatment plant in any county that doesn't volunteer to host it, and must look for out-of-state locations to take North Carolina waste. But even though the legislative ruling wipes out almost everything the commission has been working toward for 4 years, Commissioner Al Turner says all their work hasn't been for naught.
We have adopted and used guidelines that we feel will be important in selecting a new site somewhere else, some other time. So those guidelines are still in place. We're doing and continuing to study the generation of hazardous waste in North Carolina.
Turner adds, though, that he thinks the legislature is just putting off the inevitable and delaying the siting of a waste treatment plant. Meantime, the town of Cary has agreed to treat up to 50,000 gallons a day of sewage from the Bristol Myers Pharmaceuticals plant in Morrisville. The state had told the plant it needed to take some measures to treat some of its sewage off-site. In local business news briefly this afternoon, the new management of Piedmont Airlines is putting on a bright front in light of a series of resignations Friday. Piedmont's president and three vice presidents stepped down to take over at Braniff Airlines. The new president of Piedmont, Tom Schick, says the turnover won't hurt the company since the airline's strength is in its rank-and-file workforce.
The senior officers can plan and do all of the things that are right, but if the rank-and-file don't execute properly, then the airline will not be a success, and we have been fortunate in having good people.
Piedmont was bought last year by U.S. Air Group, and more management changes are expected at the Winston-Salem-based company. Published reports today say a new major manufacturing facility is heading for the Traburn project in Durham. Traburn developer Clay Hamner is quoted as saying the 550,000-square-foot factory will employ 2,000 people, but he won't name who the company is. Building activity in North Carolina's largest cities fell 16.4% this April compared to April a year ago, according to the State Labor Commission. And Edgecombe County is studying the possibility of bringing an agribusiness complex to the county for crop processing, manufacturing, marketing, administration, and research. The County Development Corporation now is accepting applications from contractors to study the feasibility of such a facility. This is WPTF News.
There's a performance feature in every new Chevrolet Beretta GT that some drivers won't know what to do with. It's called the steering wheel. That's because there are some drivers who think the most important performance feature on any performance car is the gas pedal. A feature the new Beretta GT also has, by the way. Connected to a highly potent 2.8-liter aluminum head, 130-horsepower multi-port fuel-injected V6. But Beretta also has fast-ratio rack and pinion steering, McPherson strut front suspension, trailing arm rear suspension. Because the Chevrolet Beretta was designed for the driver who's more interested in handling than in mere acceleration. So if the engineers went to all that trouble of designing the new Beretta GT to go through turns, why does it also have such a powerful V6?
to help make the stuff between the turns a little more interesting.
The heartbeat of America, that's today's Chevrolet.
WPTF News Time, now 9 minutes past 2 o'clock. Staff meteorologist Todd Glickman has our exclusive four-day forecast.
Considerable sunshine for the rest of today, but very hot and humid with a lot of haze in the air, too. Light winds out of the south and west. Temperatures in the middle 90s. There'll be thunderstorms around this afternoon and evening, a few of them containing strong gusty winds and some downpours of rain. It'll be around 70 degrees tonight with the strong thunderstorms ending. For tomorrow, partly cloudy, less humid, better visibility, and not so hot, 80 to 85. Cooling to the low 60s Monday night. Tuesday and Wednesday, fair and dry weather, sunny, seasonably warm, in the mid-80s each day. And with the WPTF four-day forecast, I'm Todd Glickman.
93 degrees currently at Raleigh-Durham International Airport. From the Triangle's news source, I'm Adam Hochberg, WPTF News.
Good afternoon. It's 2:10 on WPTF Sunday Focus. This is Tom Smither, along with Kathy Reed this afternoon. In this hour, we'll focus on the relationship between children and cholesterol.
And Reese Edwards talks with economist Mike Walden about trade and protectionism. And later on our Wall Street Journal Weekend Focus, we'll also hear about disposable contact lenses.
On our Listener's Digest,
WPTF Sunday Focus.
In our musical spotlight, 1975, Tony Orlando and Tom.
On WPTF, our musical spotlight, 1975, the year Tony Orlando and Don.
He don't love you like I love you. Temperature is 93 degrees at Raleigh-Durham International. The heat index now at 104. And at our studios in Highwood, we have a temperature of 100 degrees. Lou Adler's Medical Journal focuses now on the cholesterol risk in some children.
About 40 million American adults are said by the experts to have sufficiently elevated cholesterol levels to be considered at high risk of heart disease. Many doctors and federal health authorities are now recommending blood cholesterol testing of everyone over age 20. But there are some in the field who think even younger people should be tested, especially children of those adults in the high-risk category. Dr. Ann Goldberg is a Washington University preventive medicine specialist.
I would screen most children over the age of 2, especially in families where there's a high cholesterol level and also a lot of heart disease.
Dr. Goldberg notes that high blood cholesterol has been shown to be an inherited problem in some families. In such cases, she says daily fat intake should be limited to no more than 30% of total calories. How is that accomplished?
One can change dairy products from whole milk products to skim milk products. Skim milk, low-fat cheeses, low-fat cottage cheese, low-fat yogurt. One can also cut down on the amount of meat, fish, and chicken that one eats, take the skin off the chicken, avoid frying, have more broiled and baked foods, eat less in the way of total amount.
Such diet recommendations, however, are still under discussion. The American Academy of Pediatrics advises against being too restrictive with a youngster's diet, saying it could have a negative effect on normal growth. For Anison, this is Lou Adler with Medical Journal.
To me, you're more than a child.
has got you far all to come there. That moment is you in all that you do.
WPTF Sunday Focus, Gilbert O'Sullivan at 219, and this is Kathy Reed along with Tom Smither. And coming up, Reese Edwards and Mike Walden will be talking about trade and protectionism.
Never has paying rent seemed so senseless. Now that the Richlands offers quality living at 8 7/8 fixed rate financing. That's as low as $514.33 a month, with 5% down and all closing costs paid. See the Richlands for details. You may qualify and not even know it. Richland Run has exciting floor plans priced from $59.5. Richland Towns offers beautiful and spacious living starting at $74.5. The Richlands is your best investment opportunity in the Triangle, and one of the best locations too. Take Highway 70 West from Crabtree. Turn left onto Durley Road. The Richlands is about 2 miles on the right, not far from the Research Triangle Park and close to shopping, schools, and entertainment. At 8.78 fixed rate financing and monthly payments as low as $514.33 a month. Don't pass it up. Call the Richlands today at 787-9706. 787-9706. The Richlands, an equal housing opportunity.
My wife Sylvia says I'm only embarrassing myself by advertising on the radio for people to feed me. She says I'll never find anybody who'll be content to cook only my favorite, that fresh Holly Farms chicken, night after night after night. And for once, she's right. But I have found two very nice couples and one elderly woman in Kernersville who've agreed to make up my favorite Holly Farms dishes on alternating Mondays and Wednesdays. Why, just the other night, Miss Meyer cooked up an amazing southern fried chicken with cream gravy and mashed potatoes. It was a sight to behold. Put Sylvia's to shame. Sorry, hon, but I don't bite the hand that feeds me. So come on, folks, don't be shy. If you've got a great Holly Farms chicken recipe you're just dying to try out on somebody, write me.